Alright, so I'm talking about a good amount of topics today. So the next topic I want to tackle on this Hour of Kwonmunism number 6. Man, it's my 6th one. I feel like I've done so much more of it, but I guess that's because I'm doing it for an hour. Recording a video for an hour straight is definitely a different experience than just kind of doing videos here and there. I don't know. I mean, it's not that much different since my videos tend to be fairly long. I'm a very wordy guy. Like, I made 5 videos just in the video game Deus Ex, and each of them turned out to be at least 10 minutes or 13 minutes. I did not intend them for them to be that long, but that happened. Anyway, the next topic on this issue is, let's talk about something gaming related. I want to talk about Let's Plays, and or playthroughs or walkthroughs, videos on YouTube, and how the landscape of that might be changing a bit. It's kind of terrifying in one respect. So there's two developments, or one development and one possible development. So the one thing that is on everyone's concern right now with less players has to do with Nintendo. And they're starting to become really kind of antagonistic towards less plays. And striking at his copyright claim whenever the videos are over 10 minutes. Or I don't know why, what the reasons are. I just, some of the Let's Plays video I've seen, they mentioned that, oh, I can't, you know, like a Kabornamani 456, which is a Let's Player I really enjoy just watching. I love watching his videos of him playing Nintendo games and Sonic games. Great Let's Player. He just started the Let's Play of Donkey Kong Country Returns, the 3DS version. And as he starts, he talked a lot about, like, I don't want to make this video too long. I'm going to try to not make it be over 10 minutes, because if it's over 10 minutes, then Nintendo is going to copyright strike it and take it down. I don't know if that's a reason, one of the reasons that Nintendo is doing to take it down. Certainly, Nintendo has every right to be able to do that. Nintendo can just say that we own Donkey Kong Country Returns, so you're not going to be able to do any less play video on it. Certainly, publishers like Nintendo, Sony, Microsoft, EA, whatever, they can do that. But no one really has, because why would you? It's free marketing. Let's Play is like free marketing, pretty much. And also, like, it perfectly fits under the description of fair use, although that doesn't protect it. This particular use of fair use doesn't protect it from when a publisher like Nintendo is like, we want that content taken down because we own it. And really, Nintendo has every right to, but it's really dumb that if Nintendo is doing that, Nintendo is being really stupid. That's what I want to say, like, because that really is going to hurt them in the end. You know, a lot of people, especially with Nintendo Let's Plays, I've noticed there's a different quality to playthroughs about, like, Nintendo Let's Plays and some other Let's Plays. There's an entirely different feel to it. So there's, like, Call of Duty Let's Plays, you know, it's just, like, commentates on spectacular kill-death ratios and just whatever. And there's the other games which are more like walkthroughs, and they kind of show you how to play the game, whatever. But I feel like a lot of times, I don't know if this is just me, but whenever I watch a Let's Play of a Nintendo game, like Super Mario 3D or Pokemon or Luigi's Dark Mansion, any of these types of Nintendo games or people, or even like non-Nintendo game, but from people, a YouTuber who usually does Nintendo games, the vibe is so different. It's so different. Because the YouTuber is so energetic, and there's just such a joy in the way they talk about how they're playing the game. And usually these games are games without story, so there are hardly any cutscenes in these kind of games, you know? No cutscenes, a lot of jumping and platforming, a lot of action, and a lot of just cartoony graphics. So it's a totally different vibe, and I love it. So I feel like, you know, there is so much joy and adoration that comes you know, a lot of these Nintendo fans do their Let's Plays because they love Nintendo games. They're huge fans of Nintendo. By striking them down with copyright strikes, like, Nintendo is hurting their own fans, their own audience. It makes no sense to do that. So that's a terrifying development that's starting to happen. I honestly don't know how far Nintendo will take this, but I hope Nintendo realizes that this is going to have a huge backlash if they decide to take down Let's Plays of their games. Huge, huge backlash. It's the short benefit they get out of this effort that they're doing. It's nowhere going to cover for the backlash that's going to just destroy those short benefits. So that's the obvious, you know, that's the obvious thing that's kind of on the minds of all Nintendo Let's Players right now. I mean, if it's just the issue of videos not having to be longer than 10 minutes, that sucks. That limits creativity of Let's Players, because a lot of these Let's Players do videos that are 30 minutes, 20 minute videos, and they're really fun to watch when they don't have to worry about time limit and all that. But if that's it, at least that's it. I hope if they do anything, that's it. Don't go any further, Nintendo. Don't make it worse. Don't, because the backlash you're gonna get is, trust me, it's gonna be horrible. The other development is, of course, PlayStation 4. PlayStation 4 is, according to the conference that I watched, you know, the PS4 reveal, you know, it's being developed with this sharing video gameplay footage in mind, which I think is great in some sense, but in some sense, I don't know what's Sony going to do. Is Sony simply going to kind of link it to YouTube and make that happen? I don't know. There's so many other interesting ways Sony can go about doing this with the Let's Plays. Let's Plays could be, I think, transformed in a lot of ways by what Sony does with their PlayStation 4 and their share capability. One scenario I imagined, and I don't know if this is a good, if this is something to look forward to or this is something to fear. I don't know. I haven't really made up my mind yet about this scenario. But I imagined this scenario. Like, okay, what if Sony comes out and says, hey, this is our new, kind of like, you know, you can watch this on YouTube, it's linked on YouTube, but here's our new website that you can check out. Whenever you put the share button, your videos will go onto this website. And it's also, your video also will be double embedded into your YouTube channel. So you can go simultaneously on both things. And then you have this playthrough, right? And so, like, Sony does a little thing where it curates the Let's Plays or curates gameplay footages. And there's featured gameplay footages. And there's a lot of, you know, Sony can also make it a business where it gets a cut out of the views of playthroughs. I don't know. And that's where it gets tricky. When money gets involved, this is where it gets tricky. Could it be possible that Sony starts hiring Let's Players as their featured Let's Players, Sony Let's Players? And there's now actually like Sony employees who play video games for a living, but they're featured on their Sony webpage. These are like the featured players. I don't know, like what that's something like just imagine happening. Might not ever happen, but it's certainly a possibility with the route that Sony is going with their share button capability. That would be interesting. I wonder, like, if any Let's Player is watching this, or, you know, if I had a chance to ask any Let's Player, would you get on that? You know, if there's a company, a console company, that would like to hire you as its Let's Player, you know, you get to play as the games that are on a particular platform, and you do exclusive Let's Plays for them, and it's going to be featured on their website, and you get a cut out of how many views that video gets, and Sony gets a cut out of how many video that gets. How does that change the landscape of the Let's Play community? Well, not the entire community, but the community of that particular console. What happens? Would any Let's Player agree to do that? Would become an employee of a console manufacturer to be its Let's Player? I don't know. These are just wild thoughts that I have that I just you know, when I was thinking about Let's Plays, I was just like, that could be an interesting development that happens. Like I said, I don't know if that's something to fear or to look forward to. I honestly know that I'm not, you know, Sony is never going to ask me to do it. So this is not a personal thing, but it just makes me wonder. That could be an interesting thing where a publisher curates, you know, decides to feature which a website just for Let's Plays or just for featuring gameplay footages that is backed and handled by a publisher like Sony. Imagine that. In one way, I think that would be awesome. I think it would be really cool. But on the other hand, I feel like it could have the ramifications of that could not be so positive in the end. I don't know. So what do you think? If you guys are into Let's Plays, what do you think about that possible scenario? Do you think it's possible? Beyond that, do you think that might be a good thing or a horrible thing? I don't know. Just wanted to throw out that scenario out there. Yeah, so that's that topic.